Hi all, welcome to my classroom. I'm Lakshmi, Assistant Professor, Department of Civil Engineering, SNIT. Discussing here girder bridge, it includes continuous girder bridge, box girder bridge and arch bridges. First one is continuous girder bridge. Actually, a continuous girder bridge is a bridge supported at three or more points, and it has a capability to resist the bending moment and shear force. Actually, this continuous girder bridge is statically indeterminate structure. Okay, and the span is considerably less, and also the stresses are reduced due to negative moments developed at the piers. Okay, sound foundation is available and the span length are greater. Okay, the advantage is span are less prone to collapse, aesthetically good, and also the continuous girder bridge suffers less vibration and less cause. It requires only one bearing at the pier. And the disadvantages. Okay, these are the disadvantages. Okay, these are the examples. Continuous girder bridge. Then comes to box girder bridge. A box girder bridge is built up using deck plate, vertical or inclined verbs, and a bottom plate. And the deck plate carries heavy traffic loads, so it needs stiff stringers and transverse beams to transfer the load to the box web by bending. Okay, the bottom plates act as a cord member for bending. The box girder bridge is a bridge in which the main beams comprise girders in the shape of hollow box. Actually, the box is typically rectangular or trapezoidal in cross section. This box girder bridge is in the form of a bridge, a beam bridge. Okay, and comes to the construction. It is prefabricated offsite, fabricated offsite and lifted into the place by crane, by using cranes. Okay, and forms of box girders: rectangular box with wide cantilevering span, trapezoidal box sections, two box sections which are connected together by bracings. Okay, and these are the typical forms. And advantage: reduces the slab thickness and self-weight of bridge. It's cost effective, greater strength per unit area of concrete. And these are the advantages. And next is a disadvantage. There are two disadvantages. Structural steel girders are costly and inefficiency and transportation cost. These are the two disadvantages. And some examples here. These are the box girder bridges. Okay, these are the box girder bridges. Then the next One is arch bridge. This arch bridge is semicircular structure with abutments on each end. The design of arch, the semicircle naturally diverts the weight from the bridge deck to the abutments. Okay, arch bridge of reinforced concrete can be used and span ranges from 35 to 200 meter. Arch can in the form of arch slab or arch ribs, spans longer than 25 meter, and this is the layout. Okay, typical arch bridges. Okay, in this figure, the arches are there. Stiffener girder, stiffening girder, tie mumpers. Okay, arch bridges, three types, type A, type B, and type C. These are some of the examples. Okay, examples of arch bridge. Okay, then comes to slab bridge. It's the most common type of bridge, mainly used in crossings and waterways. Slab bridge has two fundamental features compared to the other bridges. Its span usually from 10 to 20 meters. Okay, the types of slab bridges depends upon material, timber, stone, steel and concrete. Depends upon structure, slab and beam. Slab bridges and beam slab bridges. Depends upon structures, and the advantage is simpler and cost effective. Okay, no stirrups or web reinforcement are required, and honeycombing in concrete are less than speedy construction. These are the advantages and disadvantages. Greater cost of material, the material cost is higher, and larger dead lots. These are the disadvantages of slab bridge. Okay, and this is the example figures 1, 2, 3, and 4 slab bridges. A very simple type bridge.